Hi, this is Scott Ware with Radiance Magazine, publisher and editor-in-chief, and of the Radiance channel on the Expansion Network. And I'm here at the Mindfulness Expo in Anaheim in November of 2019 with Jamie Dubin. Welcome, Jamie.
Hi, welcome. Thank you so much for having me.
Thanks for being here. So you are a breath worker and sound healer. And now, when you work with, and your company's called Harmonic Prana.
Yes, correct.
People can find you at harmonicprana.com.
Yes.
Now, what is it people can get out of breath work that would help them? What kind of people come to you for that?
Oh, there's so many different people. I've worked with people that are in sobriety, so really anyone that wants to help calm their mind, which is a lot of people, I'd say all walks of life.
Sure.
I think calming the mind doesn't really discriminate towards anybody. So I work one-on-one with a lot of cancer survivors, so people that are going through chemotherapy and need treatment. So I do one-on-one sessions weekly with a lot of people like that. People with chronic illness, because when you have chronic illness, it can be really hard to calm down the nervous system.
Sure.
And that can cause a lot of issues for the body. Even people that are healthy, stress can really negatively affect the mind and body, as we know. So this is really good for anyone. I work with a lot of athletes, moms, dads, brothers, sisters, anybody that just wants some calming and relief in their life. So I've really seen just about everybody come in.
My personal experience with breath work is interesting because at first I didn't like it. Mm-hmm. I didn't want to do it. But then I realized once I pushed through certain blocks that I had, it was so gratifying. I didn't like it at first because there was difficulty in getting to things. But I'm glad and then it was later with someone that I finally said, okay, I'm going to push through, and it felt so good. I mean, do you find that people are like, why am I doing breath work? I know how to breathe. Isn't that enough? I'm here breathing.
Yeah. Well, I think breathing is probably one of the most underrated things, and I feel like we think we know how to breathe, but how often are we actually thinking about it, right? Like, how often are we focusing on our breath and asking ourselves, am I breathing deeply? Am I breathing consciously? What is the quality of my breath?
So if we're stressed, our quality is probably very low.
It's usually very low, and that can wreak havoc on our bodies. When we're not breathing consciously, we can release a lot of cortisol. And when we get control over our breath, we really have a lot of control over our mind. We can reduce the fight or flight response and get into a rest and digest response. And I love
rest and digest.
So that really, just like it says, so it helps to rest the body, and it affects all of the body. So it actually helps your digestion, it helps your blood pressure, so it really helps people with physical conditions a lot. And you could actually measure the blood pressure and see it go down when you're doing breath work. And I do hear that a lot as far as pushing through. A lot of people think that meditation, the second they do it, it's going to be peaceful and blissful. And if it's not peace and bliss, and if your mind isn't completely still the whole time, that you're doing it wrong. And I think that's a lot to ask.
Sure.
I think meditation is kind of like a muscle, and the more that you practice at it, the more that you work through. So that's a really common thing that we hear in breath work, is that we need to go through those blockages, and we need to feel it to heal it, right? So there's that common saying, and so I think it helps
having somebody with you to feel it.
Exactly. Some guidance, because when you do things on your own, let's be honest, a lot of times we kind of slack off, right? If we're meditating on our own, I'm like, what's the dog doing? And your monkey mind goes
and then
a little crazy.
Yeah,
you're like, I meditated for 2 minutes, I'm done. So it's always nice to have coaching.
Yeah. You deal with people fresh into sobriety or even long-term into sobriety.
Both.
That's very interesting that you specifically deal with that. I imagine that can help the process, learning how to breathe, learning how to be in touch with your body.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think what it really helps with is helping them learn how to be with their feelings and be present, because a lot of people use substances to escape because it's really hard to be with what is. A lot of people that have trauma get into substances. And so I do work with a lot of trauma survivors as well, because it's really hard to sit with ourselves sometimes and have compassion for ourselves. And being with the breath gives us something to focus on. So I like using it if it's hard for someone to meditate, like if you're having trouble meditating, which a lot of us have that trouble, right?
Yeah.
Have that trouble getting into it, the breath is a great anchor. It's a very common anchor. So continuously coming back to the breath and always adding compassion to that, I like to weave that in a lot as well. Mm. It helps us be with what is and continue to come back to the anchor and be with the present moment without feeling like we have to escape.
You told me earlier that you would go to someone's house here in Southern California to work with them, and I would think that people with chronic illness, that would be particularly, because especially if they're bedridden, yeah, or if they've just had chemo and they don't want, and you know, they don't want to get out of bed.
Yeah.
You're going up and down between San Luis Obispo and Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And probably in Orange County.
Orange County. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you'll come and do bedside coaching or just private coaching for that.
Yeah.
That's something you do a lot?
Yeah, that was what I first started to do when I got into breath work, and I actually got into this because I had Lyme disease, and so it really helped me personally with my own recovery with Lyme disease. And so I had a lot of friends that I'd be like, come to a breath work ceremony with me or come to sound healing, and they were so sick they couldn't even get out of bed.
Wow.
And so I, you know, I can kind of empathize with that, and so I'm like, it's okay, I'll come to you.
Sure.
And so I really love working with people like that that can't otherwise get to those ceremonies, because I really think this is so powerful, it should be accessible to everybody. And I'll even bring my sound healing instruments too.
You bring your bowls?
Yeah, my crystal bowls. So I'll have like the whole setup and I'll surround them in crystal bowls, put bowls on the body, and it's really just such a nourishing experience. So I'll do one or the other sometimes, both together.
So that's a gift someone could give someone else.
Christmas is a busy time.
Yeah. And whether people see this, whenever they see this, they could think of someone who's not well, who could use a visitor who comes with some coaching, with some breath work and sound healing.
Yeah.
That would be great.
Yeah, I get that a lot, because a lot of family members that might be interested in this, like they have other family members that don't know a lot about meditation or wouldn't go seek this on their own. So they're like, it's okay, I'll gift it for you, and you don't have to worry about paying for it. I'll just gift it. And then I go there and they don't really have anything to lose and they try it. And most of the time they really get a lot out of it.
Very nice. That sounds amazing. So people can find you at harmonicprana.com.
Yeah.
And they can, now if they don't live in California, are there services they can get from you remotely?
Yeah, absolutely. So I do online breathwork sessions. So online is really great because you can be in your own home. You could do that if you're in California too, and you live 2 miles away from me and you just don't want to go outside and stay in your pajamas. So one-on-one is really great because it's very personalized. I do a lot of stuff in studios and retreats and festivals, but I love the connection with one-on-one, so we could talk about your goals, talk about your intentions. I can work with you and customize everything to your needs. So I really love doing that. And you can live anywhere, do the online sessions. And I also have some sound bowl tracks that have been digitally retouched, so there's no scratching from the mallets, and it's really good quality. So a lot of times people listen to that to de-stress or to go to sleep.
Very nice. That's amazing. Thank you for being here with me for this interview.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yep. Yeah, really great to meet you.
And it's harmonicprana.com.
Harmonicprana.com.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And thank you all for watching. This has been the Expansion Network.